All right. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Let's Play Disgaea D2. And what may be the finale, the final episode. Maybe. I don't know. It depends. What do you guys want to see from Disgaea? But, that's something we can get into later. Right now, as you can see, I have been playing for almost 250 hours. Now, in the grand, like, compared to how long others have been playing this game, that's nothing. I mean, like, it's 250 hours. Moving Souls 1 went on for, like, 620-ish around there. Oh, man, that was horrible. But, I've seen Disgaea can easily get into the thousands, because what I've done so far is like garbage. What I've done was just waste time, actually. But you know, I've wasted enough time to where I can actually to where I can actually take on the ultimate playthrough challenge. You know. Okay, so before we get into anything, cheat shop. Let's check the cheat shop. Okay. Let's go ahead and turn that off. Turn everything off. Set everything to special skill XP. And there will be a reason for that, which I will get into later. Okay. Enemy strength set to 0. Land of Carnage is off. Rasetsu is on. Everything else doesn't really matter. Okay. Okay, so guys, in these 250 hours, I will show you what I have been working on. Look at this trapezohedron with 619 million health and 176 million SP. And 1.8 million in everything else in the other stats. That's what I've been doing. Also, you may notice Petta has 300% aptitudes, Laharl has 300%, Valvatora is 300, everybody is like really, really high aptitudes, so I've been doing that too. But like there's enormous stat differences. Laharl has max basic stats, max Land of Carnage, not maxed equipment, I'll get into that in a little bit. Petta also has max basic and Land of Carnage, and fairly high equipment, higher than Laharl's. What can I say, I favor Petta more. Look at that, Valvatorez has like, Jack is absolutely nothing. But he has high aptitudes, that's what counts. Yeah, everybody else has like very low, except, here we go. I have Kyo, who used to be a runner. That wasn't the masked hero. Yeah. He used to be a masked hero, but I had him reincarnated into a boulevard fighter just for this video. And then I'll probably change him back into a masked runner. But yeah, he has maxed basic stats, which I got from reincarnating him 250 times. So that means I reincarnated Laharl, Petta, Kyo, and even this kill 250 times. So that's a total of 1,000 reincarnations. And, like, there are some other characters that I've reincarnated, but I haven't gotten them maxed. Nor have I really reincarnated them that much. Like, it was under 10 reincarnations, so. Yeah, they don't really have much else besides the maxed basic stats. But max basic stats is just enough to get what I need from him. So, that's good. Yeah, I said I was gonna max a bunch of people, and like, well, it'd be nice, but, it's really hard. Well, not really hard, it just takes a long time. Okay, so anyways, we can talk about that later, because I have a lot to do, actually. Alright, so here is my setup. I have a level 999 trapezohedron. This one is significantly weaker than the one I had on Peta, because of the way I played the item world for this one, which I'll get into later when I have time. Hopefully I remember all these things I want to get into. Anyways, the trapezohedron, it has Heart's Shadow, a couple hundred guardians, I mean, yeah, I got lazy. And professional. That professional, I want to say it's important. Let's just say it's important. It's not as important as these, though. The pharmacist, coffee maker, medicine man, psychologist, and social worker. Excuse me. Basically, Laharl's immune to all status ailments in the game. Fun! And on the broken cell phone, I have Aeronaut, Cryofire, and Firefighter. So, again, those are the elemental resistances. The elemental resistances will help for this battle. Actually, yeah, they would. I wouldn't recommend going in with negative elements, because you may run into problems soon. But, like, this setup? Perfectly fine. It will work for this. Mostly the Heart Shadow and the Guardian are... Heart Shadow, Guardian, and the 300% aptitudes are the most important. Because with those, then you can have, like, a really strong trapezohedron, and then just a bunch of crap. Like, I haven't leveled these items up at all. And I'm gonna go and fight with it. Peta, on the other hand, yeah, she has some handed down equipment. She has a superior trapezohedron and the broken cell phone. Which also has the all resistances, and hers has 500 guardians and the same Heart Shadow, professional, firefighter, cryophile, good stuff like that. And she has the 300% aptitudes. So, my main fighting force will be Laharl and Peta. Now, here's the, here's my ace in the hole, absorption. They both have absorption, along with their native ability. Alright, so, oh yeah, they also have maxed weapon, proficiencies. And skills? Like, I got a few to 99, but like, well, while I was running in the item world, it took forever. Oh, I can turn these on. But I didn't get all of them to 99. Because it takes forever. Like, even with a ton of weapon masteries and stuff like that, it takes forever. Jeez. So, I just focus on the important ones. Getting the skills with rank SS or S or A. Skills with A, S, or double S, those are very important. And if you can get them to 99, then that is wonderful. But like, heck, 20 works. 1 works. You don't even have to level them, but like, if you do, it makes your life easier. So, yay. Also, stay away from elemental skills like Cositus? Cositus? I don't know how to say that. But like, yeah, elemental skills are not... they are not optimal. Star works. Star is great, actually. But like, yeah, fire, wind, and ice, not so much. Okay, so... yeah, I just have like a bunch of randomly leveled skills. Apprentices, yeah. Alright. So, I have a group set up for this battle. It's gonna be coming up. Everybody knows what it is. I'm about to fight Baal right now. I mean, I'm trying to keep it like build it up, but we all know what's about to happen. So anyways, I've created my army, and like I did a test run with it, and You know, this is like over-preparing, but whatever. Better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. Which I can't really say because, like, you all saw I was super, super lazy. Anyways, absorption on my two main damage dealers. It's gonna be crazy how good it is. And then, for Kyo, he has forced counter and double counter. So, basically, I'm gonna be boosting my, attack. I think it's like combo correction, but like basically, if you attack from the same square over and over, like eventually your attacks start getting a lot stronger. So I want to build that up for this battle. And I have four angels, all have angel song and fortitude. Angel song increases attack power of adjacent units by 25%. If this battle goes anything like my test run, I won't be using it, but who knows? Maybe I can. Now, here's the big players. My Alurains? My flowers. They all have sweet aroma and fortitude. So basically they're my garden, and like they're gonna be OP and keep me alive forever. So before heading in, make sure you have tons of guardians, heart shadow. Oh man, I don't think I've explained heart shadow, have I? Basically, with heart shadow, the more people who dislike you, the stronger you get. For every person that dislikes you, you get 1% stat bonus, up to 127%, because that's how many characters you can create. Or that's how many people you can... Yeah, that's how many characters you can have. So, 127. So, it helps. Alright, so, let's do this. I feel like I'm forgetting something. Probably am. Ugh. What is this? The power of these magical waves are off the charts! Feels like the netherworld is screaming. I've never felt anything like this before. What's going on here? I thought the netherworld was out of danger now. How should I know? Don't ask me. Someone's over there, Prince. Damn it, who the hell's trying to challenge me, the Overlord? Alright, I'm pumped for this. Whoever you are, bring it on! Four, five, six, seven. Seven lightning bolts, and here he is. What? What is it, big brother? You don't look that well. That's Tyrant Overlord, Baal! Baal, however you want to pronounce it. I heard Baal, so I'm calling him Baal. Tyrant Overlord Baal? Yeah, a long time ago, King Krzyzewski failed to defeat him, but the prince managed to do what his father couldn't. Wait, Flan was there? Yeah, she was there. What are you talking about, Flan? You're crazy. But it looks like he's alive and well. Not only that, it seems he's much stronger than before. He is. Oh boy, is he. Yeah, I think he's at max level. His stats are off the chart. So an enemy from before has revived and is even stronger than ever? What an exciting development! Actually, it just means there's more work for us. Well said, Etna. Big brother, you're gonna fight that thing? Huh. I don't know how he revived, but if he plans to wreak havoc in my netherworld... As the Overlord, I can't allow that to happen. Fine, but I'm gonna fight with you. Okay, big brother? No, you're not, sister. Do whatever you want. Okay. Yes, however strong he may have gotten, we have the power of love on our side. And with that, we can overcome any obstacle. Ugh, stop spewing that garbage. You almost put me in a coma. Oh my. Huh? You still can't handle the word love? I thought you would have gotten over that by now. No, I haven't gotten over it. You made me exert some energy before our big fight. Uh-oh. He's flaming. Looks like we're all out of time to talk. Huh. This time I'll cut him to shreds so he'll never think about reviving again. Feast your eyes on the power of Overlord Laharl! Well, and with that, I remembered. Alright, so, animations are turned off, but Baal has some skills of his own. A skill of his own, Sword Rain. It'll automatically play by itself. Alright, so let's go ahead and take a look at our enemy. As you can see, Baal is a lot less lazier than I am. He took the time to dive through all four of his items, got them all to level 999, and he took like optimal leveling, except he kinda, like, he really slacked on the health and SP. But like, the base stats are very good. And then you look at Baal's base stats. As you can see, he really did not like reincarnating, so he did it zero times. That's why his base stats are so low. And that will be his downfall. Land of Carnage, however, he loves absorbing those stats, so he did that to make up for it. But as we are about to see, it will not make up for it. Alright, now this fight is a little unfair, because I don't know if you can see the new Super Time Engine there. Gives him 99 move and 99 jump, so basically he can be anywhere. Now, the big thing about the Time Engine is that you don't lose your combo correction when you move. So Baal is like constantly getting stronger the longer the fight gets, goes on. While like, if I move, then I lose everything if I move my character. Like, it will be terrible. But I won't let that happen. I hope. He also has the broken cell phone, which I don't know if I explained, but the broken cell phone basically gives you 100% accuracy, so you will never miss an attack. So Baal will never miss an attack, and he can be everywhere in one move. Ah, his abilities. Alright, he has Tyrant Overlord Analyze, which takes 0 damage from skills previously taken. Increase attack power by 0.05%. And he has Tyrant Overlord Force, attacks units dispatched from the base panel. Now that's like the entry barrier. If you can't get past this Tyrant Overlord Force, then you're not ready for this fight. And that's a good way to let you know. Also, you see Baal's resistances are 75% to all three elements, so while the elements aren't completely useless, they're only going to be dealing 25% damage anyways, so that's not that good. So don't invest too much time in leveling up elemental skills. Let's see. Baal has 5 billion stats, I believe. It's 5 billion, I'm sure. No, 500 million. I don't know, I can't count. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Whatever, he has a lot. Yeah, it's 500 million. Because the cap is 1 billion for stats. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and get Laharl out. He has the Natural Sardine. See, take 9 billion damage coming out of the base. He took 98. He had 100 billion health. So, you know, he's kind of dying.
Mr. Sunny.
Fortitude works.
It hurts.
as you can see, so I can get my flowers out. Here! And don't have to worry about them dying. Now, the thing with Fortitude is that it can always activate. It stays active for as long as your health is at max. If your health is, like, even 1 point below max, and you get hit with anything that'll kill you, you will die. So, thankfully, Terra Heal will bring them all back to full health.
Together! Together! Together!
And there we go. They all learned Terra Heal, so... yeah, it's level 2 now, so they should get, like... like the sideways angle. They also have Braveheart and magic boosting, like the boost spells, so those will help. Well, actually no, not really, because like really all I need to do is build up a combo, but like just for time's sake, I'm doing this right now. Alright, there we go. Okay, so they're all back to full health. Kyo, however, he cannot, Kyo cannot stay on the battlefield. If he does, he will die. Alright, so here's the idea. Just have him attack Laharl, and Laharl attack back. Don't worry too much about team attacks. And then just have them duke it out. Okay, so this is what I'm going to be doing until I get Laharl up to about 400%. Kind of. Yeah, 400%. Okay. Now, what I, like, if things go perfectly, then my angels will act as Laharl and Peta's legs. Basically, I'll just be tossing them around everywhere with the angels. Because, there's no way to check.
There you go!
Ha! It hardly left a scratch. Because I have a couple Barefoot X's in my inventory, so I can, like, I have 3 pairs of Barefoot X's, which give 3 move each. Oh no, why did I do that? Yeah, that's the thing, too. Like, if you leave the base panel, or if you leave the base panel, go back in the base panel, and pull the unit out again, you can get, you can basically just wipe yourself out from just Tyrant Overlord Force. Uh-oh. How did I do this last time? Oh my gosh. I may have made a mistake.
Divine guidance!
Alright, yeah, let me...
It's like wings!
I did make a mistake. Okay, so... there, kills on. Could have got stabbed for like the 4th time, so thankfully she knows Terra Heal and she can get them both back up to max. There we go. Laharl, he's not up to max, but you know, he won't be dying. Okay, so again, the angel has Fortitude. And I needed Kyo to be mounted, otherwise he's a goner. Put him right here. You can dismount. You can go on the base panel. Yeah, there we go. But if I don't get Aeon back to full health, next turn he will die. Unless he mounts on the flower, in which case he will be fine.
Together!
Keep going!
Okay, so Aeon is full health.
Knuckle!
And we are going to keep building our combo.
Knuckle! Knuckle!
You know, a funny thing that happened during my test of this, I had the flower heal somebody, and that heal leveled her up. And since level up increases your max health, she had less than full, and I had no choice but to let the flower die. It was sad. Very unfortunate, actually. Hopefully that doesn't happen again. Okay, I think everyone's up to full health. And as long as Kyo can move, he can just climb on a flower and be fine. Petal will never die because she'll be healing 50% of her health, I believe, from these two flowers. Lahara will also be healing 50% from the flowers. Oh, he's also built 174% combo. It gets harder to build as it goes on. Alright, you see, he has 10% right now. We'll see if he moves. Okay, he moved. And he used a new skill. No matter how hard he tries, he can't kill me. See? Now he has 20%. Even though we watched him move, the super time engine is OP. OP. Okay, now here's what I want. I want Terra Heal. Where is it? Oh no. This is a different flower. Oh no. That's okay. You get to watch me do this again. Actually, no, don't do that. We'll get help from Petta. We don't need the angel out right now, so I'll put him back in the base panel. Hopefully he had full health, otherwise, next time he leaves, he will die. Alright, so this is what I had in mind when I said, like, I could talk about things, because this is gonna take a while, especially if I want to do it with Petta and Lahara. It'll take a while, even with this pretty weak setup. I want to make this perfectly clear, I didn't come up with this. This was, like, based off of a... This is just like a collection of information from people all over the internet, because I did my homework. I studied the fight. I don't want to come in and just die over and over. So, I got to know my enemy, know what I'm in for. Turns out, like, this fight isn't too bad. Like, in my current condition. It's not too bad. Fortitude is OP. It's just, like, getting characters reincarnated takes a very long time. Well, it takes, like, roughly 6 to 7 hours, depending on, like, how focused you are. It could take a lot longer if you're not focused. But yeah, like, 6 to 7 hours is a good... That's quite a long time, but, like... Yeah, I don't know, there's no but, that's a long time. Ouch. Keep trying, Baal. I'm sure you'll get us somehow. Yeah, having Terra Heal on these flowers basically keeps them alive forever. And their passive healing heals percentage. So...
Knuckle!
It's too good. It is way too good. Alright, so... I know I wanted to talk about the item world, so I will talk about my experiences in the item world. Let me tell you, it was not fun. Oh boy. Like... Yeah, every day. Oh no, I forgot. There we go. Yeah, every day I would come home from class and turn on Disgaea and start grinding. Specifically, I would head into the item world, and my trapezohedron that Peta is wearing. And I would work on that, because the... what am I doing? Because I want...
This is my final arc.
Like, I want one character, at least one character, to hit 400 billion HP and SP. Because right now I'm at 200 billion HP and SP. Or more like 215. But like, 215, and I've spent all this time leveling the item. I'm like not even anywhere close. And like, leveling items is pretty complicated. Oh no. Oh no. Okay, so basically this is a repeat of what happened last time. That's good. That is good. Okay. So, 300% is okay, but this is gonna be a one-man show now. Fed up. I wanted her to do good. Crap. That's what I get for being absent-minded. Okay, so... well, I guess the fight will begin. Alright. So, Baal's ability won't let him take damage from the same skill twice. But, different people can use the same skill and it will do damage. So, basically, it's harder for a solo person to do it. To do damage. Alright, here we go. First, I'm going to have Laharl... I'm gonna have to throw him around everywhere. And since Peta doesn't really have a combo, we can use Peta. Okay, so what I'm going to want to do is not use a fist. I want something with some range. Ah! An axe! Yeah, why not? When you look at the massive stat drops, that's why not. Okay. So I could use that. It won't really do any damage. Despite how big Baal is, he only occupies one square. Okay, so... El Diablo is a E power skill, so... I have no problem using it. You wanna fight me again after what I did to you before? I'll crush you into a million pieces so you'll never be able to come back again.
Here I come!
El Diablo! Yeah, this is one I haven't seen yet, so it's playing the animation for it. Kill him! Kill him hard! Yeah, you're an eyesore. Ouch. So, he has, sorry, he has 100 million health. Why do they say that? That's so creepy. Why does she say it hurts? Well, I mean, like, she said it hurts and then got stabbed with a sword. But, like, she said it hurts before the sword stabbed her, so... something else was hurting her. Axe Wheel WMD, I can use that. It's a...
it hurts!
D rank, so it's not that great.
Let's play!
Okay,
divine guidance!
Ooh. Okay. So, let's heal up. With the flowers.
Hey, fit! Together!
I want to,
together!
Well, I just have the flowers out so I can have this angel out. If he takes damage, he'll heal back to full, and then I can use him as to throw around Peta and Mahar.
Ow. Ooh, the counter.
Yeah, the analyze also works for basic attacks, so it is possible to, like, it's possible to get to a point to where you do absolutely no damage because you've used all your skills. And, like, I think that's pretty cool.
See?
That's pretty
it's like
cool.
Wings.
Forces you to grind. Ha! Which is... I can see how people would think that's not cool, but... it's cool. Okay, let's use the Cupid. Yes. And then I'll have Peta use, El Diablo. No, she can't hit. But with the loop, she can. Actually, I want to use Boulder Crush. It's rank E. It sucks. I want to save my higher, ranked skills for more problematic for later on in the fight. Because this fight is multi-staged.
Let's begin!
Yeah, this fight is multi-staged. Baal has six? He has five other forms after this.
Together!
No problem!
I won't go
yeah. Five other forms after this, and some of them are not cool. The last two in particular, I find not cool. Okay, actually, what we can do... No. I'll save that for later. You know, he doesn't seem interested in finding the angels. I mean, that's fair, because, like, he won't be able to kill them anyways. But then by that logic,
it's like wings.
He won't be able to kill Laharl and Peta either, so... keep trying, Baal. Yeah, this first form is going to take me a while.
Divine guidance!
Oh! Just because, well, my boosting got cut short. So that sucks. Oh no, I hit the hole. Yeah, my boosting got cut short. And... I also have to keep track of... Oh, did you see that 2... The 2G counter from Laharl? Also, please do not counter. Like, if Baal counters back, he will die. Ah. Crazy angel. Alright, we've almost got him semi-down. I can go ahead and use this now. SSNIS certification. It's SS rank. But, like, it's so short range that, like, I probably won't be able to use it later, so I might as well use it now. Same thing with, I already used Boulder Crush, so let's... Axe Wheel. Yeah, Axe Wheel. Because Laharl's already used Axe Wheel.
Yeah!
And Peta's in healing range, so that's good.
Okay.
Yeah, basically if you're... What happened? What the heck? I swear I healed him back to full. I did, didn't I?
Together!
Well, that's just rude. Also, I think he had all the shoes on him, too. Oh man, you are such a jerk. But that's fine. The first form's almost dead, so that means, like, everyone needs to get away right now. I'll try not to kill him. Actually, that might not be too much of an issue.
It's like wings.
It's like wings, but not really. Okay. Yeah, just keep going with the bow. As for Peta, make her use Zeta.
It's like wings.
Run, flower. Go! Save yourself. Actually, Laharl's getting a bit low, so I'll give him the lollipop. Yeah, I'm going into this fight with two lollipops, one sardine, and just a bunch of random legendary weapons. With only staves being leveled. Ooh, I can hit him with that. Netherworld loot. There we go. But yeah, the lollipops have an ability on them where... where at the end of your turn, or... No, at the start of your turn, if you have the lollipop equipped, you will recover 50% of your health. You can see how that'd be useful, right? It's amazing, really.
It's like wings. Go!
There we go. He's in. And he has 8 billion health, so... 8 billion? Really? Can I cattail him? Can I sea dragon bang him? Can I nether news him? No, these are all elemental. And then... Ooh! Ooh! Yes, I'm gonna do this. Alright, so first form down, now he's in the second form where his ability that his, I think it was Tyrant Overlord Force, I already forgot it, but his second ability changes now to Tyrant Overlord Pandemic, where at the end of his turn, he will cause all status ailments to all of my party members all the time. So it sucks. Infinite range, if you're on the map, you're infected. But Laharl and Peta don't have to worry about that. Also, since Peta dealt the final blow, she absorbed 20% of 500 million. Now, her stats are insane. Yep, she's hit 800 billion. 800 million, I'm sorry. That doesn't apply to her health and SP though. No, that's too bad. But, now Peta can start doing a lot of damage. But, counter to that, I'm gonna have to give up somebody's combo. And since Peta's is smaller, I'm willing to sacrifice hers. And I highly doubt I can hit 100 million on Baal. Right. I'm pretty sure...
Mr. Sunny! It hurts! Here!
I don't know, let's do this. Yeah, because, you don't get hurt from leaving the base panel anymore, so that's good.
Let's begin!
Ah, actually, I didn't do this last time.
Everyone's voice fuels my courage.
But Kyo also has 42. He has 20 movement range, so he can practically go wherever he wants. And this form is a bit of a pain. I kind of want to get it out of the way. I'm not going to use my SS yet, but I will use an A. And I'm pretty sure Kyo is dead now, because pandemic. Yeah, poison killed him. What a jerk. Alright, they are all infected with everything ever. Why did I bring them out? Why did I do that? I don't know, because I wanted to waste units. Alright, so the S-bar. This is probably a terrible idea. But I don't know why I brought them out. It's because I'm greedy, that's why. I wanted to be able to toss Peta around. Yeah, okay, so I used Aura Punch. So I can't use that anymore. Actually, Peta doesn't have to move. Neither does Laharl. Alright, Baal. Prepare to get nuked. Prepare to get nuked. Gonna hit him with Terra Fire twice. See? 3G. And they kind of blocked that, but I'm sure he hit 6G. Alon is dead. That really sucks, actually. But now I have all the time in the world. It's closer. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of these elemental spells. I should have Peta go first for combo damage. Since Laharl has the big combo. Laharl has a 311% bonus. Peta has 105. That's not bad, actually. In addition with her insane stats that she stole, basically. Just slowly chipping away at him. But this next turn is where, like, we're gonna do huge damage to him. See, he has that neat animation and everything, but, like, I don't even feel it. What are you doing? Stop that. Alright, here we go. Big damage. Terra Star, level 99. Suck it. 16, 25. He didn't die? What? Oh. Well, you are full of it, man. Okay. So... another Peta kill? Really? I gotta have something that's like stupid long range. Doppelganger? Oh. Psycho Mirage. No, really? Fire Gods? Nope. Terrifying. Yeah, I already used those. What can I do? I want Laharl to get this kill. I think I'm just gonna wait. Hold on to a lollipop and wait. Okay, he moved. And he moved close enough, so... he just killed himself. Alright, on to the next phase. So... Psycho Mirage, not even necessary. Ah, actually, Doppelganger is rank B, Psycho Mirage is E. Psycho Mirage won't even kill, so... ooh, we'll throw on this tambourine and hit him with Zeo Reagan. I don't know how to say that. Obviously. Yeah, we'll use Zeo Reagan. I don't know. Feel free to correct me. But I don't want to get that out of the way because it has small range. So, boom, you're dead. Now Laharl got stat absorption, which also stacks with his Overlord's dignity, so he gets... I don't know which comes first. I don't know if he gets 10% of the 20%, or if he gets like 10% after the 20% of life. Whatever, let's not think too much about it. Just know that Laharl got stronger. And Baal is staying the same. The only thing that's changing is his ability. Now phase three, if you have the broken cell phone, is probably the most pointless phase. Cause now he has a 50% chance to avoid all attacks. Well, good for you, but I will never miss. It will not happen. Oh, he also got a new skill. Yes, Grand Sword. In one of his later forms, he'll also gain access to another skill. Pretty cool. Did did some damage. But not enough. Oh man, he also walked up and pet his face. Guy is brave. Alright, since this phase isn't that much of a problem, go ahead and use a C skill. Did I use Dark Speaker on him? Probably not. I used Cannabis, okay. Meteor Kick? Kinda wanna use Doppelganger, but... Galaxy Comet? Oh, nope, haven't used that. Fire Dragon Gods! That's rank C, but like, it's not really that strong anyways. I don't know, the range is kind of weird. Oh well, whatever. Damage is damage. And Laharl's taking a lot of it. Like, I'm surprised because like, yeah, I have a whole bunch of stats. Like, I have a 200 million stat difference on him, but he can still hurt me. In the item world, like, if an enemy had like 900 million resistance or something, and I had like 800 million int, I wouldn't be able to do any damage. I don't know what's up with Baal, why he's like such a cheater, but I'm just saying, like, if I was in the situation, I wouldn't be doing any damage to him. Oh man. Trying to fight while not moving is the most awkward thing ever. Let me tell you. Bust out the tambourine again. Speak up. Oh, Cannabis? Yes. Meteor? Yes. But Cannabis first, because it's shorter. So, who should get the stats this time? I'm thinking Laharl. Ow. Walked up and pet his face again. What a jerk. But this time, gonna shoot him with... Yeah, I did use Galaxy. And Psycho Mirage. Okay, I'm running out of skills for the bow. Oop, hit him with Zeal, and then Aura Punch him out of here. Hi-ya! Wow, he's still count. Oh, this guy's crazy. Okay, so, Laharl's getting a little low. So, let me go ahead and give him the lollipop. Yeah, in case you haven't been able to tell, this fight is a lot easier with more than one person, really. Like, if you only have one person, that one person... I don't know. Like, I don't know how you're gonna get that one person to move around and keep a combo going. He also has to be pretty strong, like... This is a team effort, really. what was I? I should give Peta the lollipop, too. Her health is getting a little low. Like, kind of a little tiny, maybe. Aw, oh, that's so lame. Did I use Time Driver? Well, I can't use... Ah, Peta Beam! Yes! No, dang. I know what I can use. Oh, but I can't. Laharl's gonna die. Okay. Nope, can't put him in prison either. Ooh, let me put the fist on and use Peta Beam. Actually, is the staff better? Staff elf offers a lot more stats, but... Oh no, that's worse actually. Effective fist. Darn. What I can do.
Let's play!
My flowers! Braveheart!
Divine Guidance!
And. No, not you.
Mr. Sunny!
Mr. Sunny, yay! Never mind. Okay, just Braveheart then.
Together!
Now, oh wow, still really? Oh man. I was hoping the game was doing that thing where it lies. Really? 17 million health? Really? That's like... At this point, that's like nothing. Might as well have lived with one health. I think Baal has fortitude too. Well, even if he did have that, that wouldn't really matter because... I'm not strong enough to one-shot him. That would be like... That would require me to have like max combo. And then use like a double S at level 99. I could probably kill him. With max stats. Probably. Alright, so Baal is in my face again. So... I'm gonna bust out the leak. And... Blade Rush. Yeah, take that. Alright. So now phase 4. He gets Tyrant Overlord Legion, where he creates ally units at the end of his turn. Now, these guys aren't really that much of a problem, really. They're more of an annoyance, and they aren't really that. Like, actually, I take that back. Like, they can do a good chunk of damage. And if anything, they help build a combo for Baal. Yeah, we're holding Overlord Dimension, because that is OP. I want Lahal to have the lollipop for one more turn. Just so I feel better about it. Would have been smart if I defended. Yep, there they are. Ball slaves. They come with legend emblems. I don't know if you can steal them. And they have all three Terra spells, which are all elemental, mind you. So that's where the resistances come in. And they cannot hurt each other or Baal. So if you wanted them to help you fight Baal, try to trick them, no, it won't work. It's not like they do any damage to him anyways. Look at their stats. I mean, they're practically like... Actually, they have really high stats. I didn't know their stats were like that. But... They're elemental, he has really high resistances, it wouldn't work out anyways. So don't worry. But, having the small balls out, kinda makes it dangerous for your fortitude guys, because they can just, like, team up and kill them all, so... That sucks. Alright, let's hit him with Muso Slash. And he's been asking me to use the skill on him. Yo, Meteor Sky Spear. Also, check that out. Penta hit max stats. She is the strongest. It's just that her combo isn't as high as Laharl's, but it is getting really high. Yeah, see that? They kind of hurt. Is he in Laharl's face? Oh, good. Then I can dimension rush him. Cannot do that. Sky 9 slash, hold that for later. Super Cross Lord, hold that for later. I can... No, I can't. Jeez! What is this spacing? I guess I can use the gun. It's not that great, because the strongest one is Water Elemental, and it won't be doing that much damage. But... Whatever, damage is damage. There we go. Uh-oh. Zero. Of course. Oh, stop that. Yeah, shoot him all in the face. Okay, Peta needs the lollipop. Hey, lollipop. And at this point, swapping equipment has no detrimental effect because Peta's max stats. You know, from this shot, it looks like he's wearing a crown. I don't know, it's like really tiny, so I wouldn't be surprised if you couldn't see it. I can't really do anything. Yeah. I'm just gonna slap on a lollipop, defend, and call it a day.
Yeah, put him in jail. Ooh.
You teleport in my face again? Okay, Peta's like really low. And now she's not. Alright, so I'm gonna netherworld loop those guys. Ooh, he's in my face. I can't kill him with a helmet crush? What? Dynamic moon? No. Yeah, of course I have to plasma sky him. Actually, I might want to do that, because, well, he's already here. Oh, and Laharl gets stabbed. What the heck? Now he's all. Now he's a pretty cool gold color, and he got his final skill, Grave Eternity, and he is eager to use it. Ouch! Hey, stop that! Stop it! You're not even doing damage. Alright, so, Baal's new ability is Tyrant Overlord Disaster. Deals damage to enemy units at end of turn. On top of the damage he already does to us. So, yeah. However, that ability can be blocked out by the cat ears. So, take that. But it's only every other turn, so... Alright, both Laharl and Peta both have maxed stats. Laharl has high has a high combo thing. And we only have like two more forms to go. And I can't reach him again. Ooh, just kidding. Gonna drop a meteor on him. Oh, and I'm gonna kill them too. Alright, Baal, your move. Oh, crap. Went further away. Yeah, and then he blew us up. But, not doing enough damage to beat the lollipop. Give him the Marduk. Marduk. Yay! Then Peta can use the Pinnacle Shooter. Oh, she already used that. Okay. Out of range. Well, that's just terrible. Icicle Sword Gun? Well, that would suck anyways. No! What do I do? I wish I had something that hit from freakishly far away. Ooh. It's not quite freakishly far enough.
Let's begin.
No.
Divine
you need
guidance.
More movement. Let's see.
I'll teach you a lesson.
Yay! Sardines! I like the Disgaea 4. Well, since I'm here, I might as well. Oh yeah, I'm gonna... Actually, like, he might die. Oh, nope. You know, that just really hurt him. Uh-oh. Yeah, goodbye, Valvatoris. I'm so sorry. And now Pet is stranded. She is stranded. Rah, 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 rah. Oh, no, I'm out of range. Whatever, man. We're close to the end. Laharl's got this. Let's hit him with Patriot? Patriot. Die! Oh, yeah, here's his final form. And I still haven't gotten rid of these things. Ugh, I'm gonna kill them. Yeah, they take that. And our base is dead. Well, that's his final ability. He kills our base. But he also heals 20% HP and SP. So if you start dealing damage and you don't kill him fast enough, this is pretty much where you go down. And like, now he's just a huge shadow. But yeah, like, Valhalla is like on stat overkill right now. But it's his show now. You know, just hopefully he doesn't die. If Laharl dies, that's kinda gonna suck. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Ow! Oh. Yeah, that's what you get. Oh no, the 20%, but Laharl has to heal. Dynamic? Nope. Plasma? Nope. Loop? Yay! I can offset some of the healing he's doing. But he's healing 20, I did 6. Nice try there, Baal. Can I send him to the Shadow Realm? No, I cannot. Not yet, not yet. I can big bang him. Ooh, that'll hurt. What's something that has... I know this Baker's Dozen slash has B, and I can't even hit it. That's E. No, that's terrible. I don't know, like, I'm out of ideas. Bash his head in with a leak. For Miku, do it for Miku. Yeah, I just used that. Oh man, I'm just so close. So close, so close, so far. Muso? What, Nether, I mean? Okay, 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 okay. Yeah, let's settle with Dimension Sword. Ow! Man, he really wants Laharl dead. But Laharl wants him dead too. So, reached an impasse. Crap. Okay, okay. Alright. You know, hopefully he doesn't do like a 70... 71 billion. I'm too scared. Ouch. Yeah, he's basically back to full health. But I know I didn't use an S-ray. No, I did. There we go. Take that. Stop, dude. Go, Petta. You are my legs. Ah, see. Oh yeah. Slowly chipping away at him. Ho ho ho. Ho ho ho. Back to full health, I see. That's good. That means back to the leak. Where's my leak? Here it is. Man, all that yellow's burning my eyes. Let's use Dark Knight because it is not as far ranged as the 9 slash. So. Okay, I think Baal's all nice and tender now, so... Woo! Yes! Hold that ball. So, for that, we get Great Ball Horn and his super cheat engine. And Laharl gets the title Tyrant Overlord. It's game over. He has nothing to say. And instead, powers up? Big Brother, the Tyrant Overlord's charging up an immense amount of power. Damn it! What was the point of our last fight? Uh-oh. He got his level 1 sword. Bring it on! Oh! Ocarina of Time strats. Wow! That was a little anticlimactic. Huh? Where'd he go? Did we defeat him? No, I think he just ran away. If what we just did was enough to defeat him, King Krzyzewski would have defeated him. You're such a big guy, he sure was able to run away quickly. This is gonna be a pain. Guess we'll run into him in Disgaea 5. Huh? Huh? But I'm sure we dealt him massive damage. He shouldn't be able to cause too much trouble. So, are you just gonna let him go? Hell no! Send the Prinny Squad to find him! Prinny 3? Wait, wasn't Baal in one of the Prinny games? Yeah, I don't mind sending them, but don't forget to pay them, Prince. I do it whenever I feel like it. Anyway, I didn't know there was anyone that terrifying in the Netherworld. Maybe he'll be even more powerful the next time we see him in Disgaea 5. Huh, I don't care how strong he gets, cause I'll be even stronger. Just you wait, Tyrant Overlord Baal. I'll find and defeat you again! For the sixth time. Alright, so that is it. Laharl's class is now Tyrant Overlord as opposed to Overlord. I was granted the Great Ball Horn, ultimate sword made from a Tyrant Overlord's sword, and now I have a super time engine of my own. Basically, I can move anywhere on the map, anywhere I want. It can even be used in the item world. You can use it to teleport directly on a gate. You don't, like, you go through units, obviously. Like, you saw how it worked. Ball is teleporting everywhere, and you can build combos with it. So with that, if I use the Super Time Engine, I could solo Ball now. With just one character, I can take him out, because I don't have to worry about, combo. So yeah, good times. And the Great Ball Horn has some impressive base stats. Like, I wonder how good the growth is. Also, I don't even know if, like, I wonder if it's better than the rank 40 sword, the ball sword, I think. Yeah, I didn't even bother to get it. Let me go ahead and favorite these. I'm gonna have to, well, yeah, I'm gonna have to eventually, level up the time engine. You know, or not. Alright, so data shop, special skill record? No. Netherworld records. Yep, here we go. Okay, so 250 hours, 100 billion max damage, max total damage, 111 billion. Defeated 75,900 enemies. That's a clean number. Wow, that means Baal was the 75,900th enemy I've defeated. Cool. Max level is the max level. Max reincarnations, 252,034 reincarnations. Yeah, hell given a lot. Yeah. All these fun stats. Wow, I've spent 16 trillion, I've healed 16 trillion health, 1 trillion SP, 701 revivals, 36 deleted characters. Been in the item world, visited the item world 509 times. Cleared 7,648 floors. That's nothing. Like, I think that if you cut that number in half, that's how many floors you would have to do for one item, for one trapezohedron to max it out. Like, around 3,000 floors to make it max if you have other trapezohedrons with those same stats. Or something like that. I was reading into it. It's a lot. It's a lot. Yeah. Ship collection rate. I have all of them. Skill collection. I don't have all of them. That's because I haven't leveled up all the monsters yet. Oh my gosh. Strong enemies defeated situation. What? They didn't even count my... What the heck are those two? What are these? What are the others? Like, they didn't count Pringers. Huh. I guess I'll have to look into that. But, yeah, guys, as you may know, a Let's Play for me isn't over until we get that shiny platinum trophy. And you know, actually, I'm confused why I didn't get it. Why they don't have a trophy for defeating Baal? Does that just take too long? Because, like, I can understand that. They figured nobody wants to do that. Huh. Yeah, I have, like, almost all the items. I don't know what... Well, okay, yeah, I do know. I know exactly what I'm missing, actually. You want to know what it is? It is the rank 40 weapons. I'm missing a lot of them. Oop, froze the game. Yeah, like Yoshitsune, then Ball Sword, and the Great Ball Horn. Yeah, that's. Oh, what am I doing? I got the ball horn before I got the ball sword. Let's see... I'm missing the legendary spear, or the rank 40 spear. I'm missing the rank 40 bow. I'm missing rank 40 everything except for staff, melee monster, and fist. Book. Missing rank 40. I have the legendaries of rank 39. I just haven't bothered to go down to floor 100 and take all those items. Even though it will take me like an hour at most to get to floor 100. And now that I have the time engine, it won't even take that long. Like, I can just rush the floors and get there. So, yeah. Once I do get the rank 40 weapons, I could do an expedition of all these. Well, I don't have all the rarities, but I almost have all the weapons. If you guys are interested in seeing what they all look like, I could show them off once I find them all, because if I am going to show them off, I want to have them all. So not all rarities, mind you, but, like, I want all the items at least. Because that's worth a trophy. Skills. I have to collect all the skills, because those are trophies. Unique. I need to level people up so that they unlock all their unique abilities. Yeah, these are all of Baal's skills. Wow, look at what? See what this guy was working with? He's such a... Ugh. He's so whack. Anyways, yeah. I could go through all of these if y'all are interested. Or I could just, like, cut to me getting all the trophies. individually. Alright guys, so with that, that's just about it. We beat Baal. All that's left to do is watch some skills and get those rank 40 items. I don't know why I fought Baal before I got the items, but you know, I'm crazy. I'm not sure exactly which trophies I'm missing, but yeah, you know, I could look them up. It won't take me that long. So guys, you let me know if there's anything you want me to go over. I'm pretty sure I missed something, like missed something to talk about how I prepared for Baal, because like, I don't know, it all seems like common knowledge to me, and because of that I feel like I didn't explain things properly, which is a real shame, because like, darn, because I like to be the educational guy. But yeah, if there's any questions or anything, feel free to let me know. If oh gosh, if you want me to fight Baal at max Land of Carnage, max rank difficulty, all stars, Rasetsu, all that good stuff. Same thing for Pringer X or whatever. Go ahead and let me know. But as a disclaimer, I will say this right now, it will take me forever to grind for that. It will take me forever. Jeez. But if you really want to see it, I don't know how much more item world I can handle in a row. I don't know, maybe I could take a break and come back to it. I could probably do Max Prinnies, but Max Baal, probably not. Not anytime soon. Because, like, I would have to add an extra 1,000 hours to prepare for Max Baal. Because leveling, maxing out items is, like, pretty difficult for me to understand. Maxing out items efficiently, that's the thing, efficiently maxing them out. Anyways, in case you can't tell, I don't know why you would, but like, my voice is getting really, it's getting kind of weird, and that is because it is 5:30 in the morning, and I have class in a couple of hours, so I'm gonna do my homework and go to sleep. So, with that, guys, I hope you enjoyed. Hope you enjoyed my battle with Baal. The Let's Play isn't quite over yet. I could do a character skill exhibition if y'all are interested, or if not, I could just get the trophies, show off the platinum, and then that's it. Like, I started this Let's Play like 2 years ago, man, when the game first came out, and then I just like dropped it out of nowhere. And now it's almost done. It's just about done, really. So that's amazing. I don't know what I'd be moving on to next for PS3. Huh. I'm feeling a little Atelier. Maybe I could finally start Neptunia? Who knows? I'm open to suggestions. But, yeah. Guys, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to... Jeez, what do I normally say? Ugh. I am tired. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to join me again next time. Where, well, I'm gonna be working on getting all the rank 40 items. So, yeah, that'll probably be the next thing I do. So, with that, I will see you all next time.